Whenever I make a DaVinci Resolve color grading tutorial, I always talk about color space transforms and layer nodes and scopes, but some of you told me that it's too much, it's too difficult, because you just started using DaVinci Resolve 17, and I completely understand, so that's why today I'm gonna show you a super simple grade. What I want to do is make you familiar with some of the basic tools. That's the point of this video, just to get you started, you know? Boom! Boom? What was that? Okay, but before we start, two things. First of all, the problem with color grading tutorials, I find, is that unless you're using the exact same footage, you'll never get the exact same result, because every clip is different and you're all shooting on different cameras with different picture profiles in different lighting conditions with different colors in the frame, you know what I mean? So that's why there's a link in the description and you can download a few seconds of the same footage that I'm using in this video. Of course, you can use whatever footage you want, but then you'll have to tweak the settings, the contrast, the colors, depending on what your footage looks like. Okay, and then secondly, well, color grading is super subjective. For me, the point of color grading is to make your footage look not realistic. If you want a realistic look, then just look at the news and make your footage look like that, because that's realistic, that's what the eye sees. Color grading is about creating a specific look, not realistic. But just because it's not realistic doesn't mean that it should look wrong. It still should look believable, you know what I mean? In almost every movie you see, the colors and the contrast are not realistic. It's not how the eye sees the world, how your eye sees the world. But it all looks right. You never think, that looks so weird, because when you're watching a movie and you think that while watching the movie, then there's something wrong with the color grade. Okay, but let's just get started, because that was the whole point of this video, just get started. Don't forget to download the clip if you want to use it and drop it on the timeline in DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so let's select our clip in the timeline and go to the color tab down here. Now, the first thing you should know is that DaVinci Resolve works with nodes to color grade. And nodes are very similar to layers. I mean, they're not exactly the same, because you can do some crazy shit with nodes, but in this example, you can think of them as layers. Make sure the nodes are visible, that's this button up here, and we need three nodes. Use shortcut Option S to add a node. And for Windows users, I think Alt S, but I'm not sure. So you can also just right click and then add a corrector node. So three nodes. Now right click, select Node Label, and let's name this node White Balance, the second one Colors, and the last one Contrast. So these are just basic serial nodes, similar to how layers work. You could actually see it like this. This is the bottom layer, then this is the second layer, and this is the third layer. That's what the final result will look like. Okay, now what I want to do is start with the last node, the contrast, because it's gonna be easier to see what we're doing when there's some contrast in the image. And there are different ways to add contrast, but we're gonna keep it simple. We're going to use contrast and pivot. Select the little wheel icon here, and then here you can see contrast and pivot. Contrast is what it says, it's contrast, and you use pivot for the midtones. Let me show you. Make sure to show the waveform here. So if you haven't added any contrast, pivot doesn't even work. See, I can move it up and down, but pivot doesn't work. So let's add some contrast now. Let's say around 350 for now. And now when I use pivot, it moves the midtones up and down. You can see it here in the waveform. The shadows at the bottom and the highlights at the top stay the same, but all the midtones shift. So you always use pivot in combination with contrast. And now it's just a matter of finding a contrast that works for you. Just experiment a bit. The great thing about adding contrast like this is that it adds a gentle filmic contrast. Unless you overdo it, of course. I think I want it a bit darker because she's in the shadow, so I'm gonna set the pivot to around 470. Okay, and now let's go to the first node, the white balance. The only settings we'll adjust here are temperature and tint. Oh, right, and if you click on the first node and the contrast disappears, use shortcut Shift H. or click on this little icon right here. Okay, now I shot this clip at sunset, but I find that the color balance is a bit too warm. I want the shadows to look a little bit cooler, especially here in the jacket. So let's make it a bit cooler. Let's say temperature to minus 300. See the jacket now? There's a little bit more blue in there, but the sunny parts in the background still look nice and warm. And I feel like there's also a bit too much magenta in the image. So let's set the tint to -6. And look, this is all very subjective. It depends on what you're going for, of course. I mean, this is too much, but anything between -10 and +10 looks okay. It just depends on what you like. Okay, and now we can get creative and tweak the colors. So I still feel like I want more blues in the shadows, but also in the highlights. So it's time for the color wheels. Let's select the second node and then here the color wheel. And then make sure that you select the third dot here. What you want is shadow, midtones and highlights and not the lift, gamma and gain wheels. And then pull a bit of blue into the shadows, away from the warm orange, yellow, red tones. And then do the same for the highlights. This creates a bit of a, I don't know, a more edgy look. Okay, it's starting to look really good now, but let's tweak some more colors. The grass here in the foreground is also in the shadow, so I feel it could use some more blue. So let's select the curves here and then hue versus hue, the second dot. Here you can see all the colors in the frame. So what I want to do now is change the color, the hue of the greens. Let's try it. Let's click here and here. So we get all the greens. And then when I pull that line up, the greens will turn red. And when I pull it down, they will turn more blue. And that's what I want. Okay, and then finally, I feel like the background is a bit too faded. So back to the last node. And here I'm gonna pull down the gamma. That will bring down those midtones and add some punch. And maybe also let's add some saturation. Okay, now what you should always check is the skin tones, because everything we did now also affected the skin tones. We didn't use power windows to isolate the skin and things like that because we kept it simple. So make sure that the skin tones are okay. Select the last node, go to power window here, add a circle window, position it over the face and then hit Shift H to isolate the face. Then select the vector scope here, and what you see here now is just the skin tones that we've selected here, and they should be on this skin tone line. If you don't see that line, you can make it appear here. And it seems like the skin tones are on that line or at least close to it. That's what we want. So skin tones are okay. And that's it, guys. Now, look, maybe this is not the 100% correct way to color grade, let's say, S-Log footage, but the point was to make you familiar with some of the basic tools, you know? To get you started. Because I know it's daunting sometimes when you look at some color grading tutorials. And I hope this easy version, you know, makes it easier to get started. And once you get more familiar with these basic tools and the process of color grading in DaVinci Resolve, then you can move on to more complicated tutorials that show you how to color grade according to Hollywood standards. But I think the way I showed it right now, you can still get pretty good results, right? So thank you for watching and see you in the next one. That was weird.